This video will provide you with a tour of the Chromebook interface. In this video, we will show you what a Chromebook looks like on sign-in and how to start using it. We'll show you how to use the sign-in, the launcher, manipulate settings, personalize the look of the Chromebook, and finally sign out and power off. Want to make the most of this tutorial? Pause this video, grab a Chromebook, and follow along. Locate the power button on your Chromebook and push it to turn on the device. Depending on your Chromebook model, the power button may be near the keyboard or on one side. A few seconds later, you will see a pop-up that says, "Sign into your Chromebook managed by SMUSD," with a place to enter your username. Students in SMUSD sign into Chromebooks with their Google usernames, which are grad year, first initial, last name, and last five digits of the student ID number. Their password is their date of birth in reverse, year, 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 month, month, day, day. If a student does not know this information, teachers can look it up in Synergy. Teachers can log into Chromebooks with the same username and password they use for the computers in their SMUSD cloud. When you sign into a Chromebook, your device will look like this. On the bottom left, you will see a magnifying glass called the launcher and some icons on your shelf, which you can customize. On the bottom right, you will see an icon and some other symbols. Clicking on the icon opens up the status tray. Access all your apps from the handy launcher or magnifying glass. Here you can open apps you already have, get more apps from the Chrome Web Store, and search all of your apps or the web. You can pin your favorite or frequently used apps to the shelf located next to the launcher. To do this, right-click on an app and select Pin to Shelf. While we're on the subject of personalizing the shelf, you can also change where the shelf appears by right-clicking on the desktop background of the Chromebook. Another option here is to change the wallpaper desktop background. Let's move on to the status tray located in the bottom right of the Chromebook. The status tray shows the current state of your network, battery, and more. Check out the question mark located at the bottom of the status tray. That is the help menu, where you can find lots of information about the device. You can also sign out, lock, or shut down within the status tray. The settings gear in the status tray contains all the options for the Chromebook, including appearance and touchpad settings. You can also change your personal icon here. At the bottom of the settings pane, you can click Show Advanced Settings to show even more, including accessibility settings. Accessibility settings can be very useful for students with special needs. You might also find that students manipulate the accessibility settings and can't turn them back off. If a student complains of an extra large mouse cursor, an on-screen keyboard, or a Chromebook that is talking back, check the accessibility settings. When you want to adjust sound or brightness, look for the sun or speaker keys on the top row of the Chromebook keyboard. Tap the keys to increase or decrease brightness or sound. To sign out of a Chromebook, click into the status bar and click Sign Out. This will take the Chromebook back to the login screen. From there, a student can choose to shut down by clicking an option on the computer screen or choose to hold down the power button to power completely off. If students power off completely while signed on by holding down the power button or selecting the shutdown button, the Chromebook will automatically log them off. Thank you for watching the Chromebook interface tour.